I have no choice but to do so. I cannot supply water to the people of this town with called for them, as the well was destroyed. So I have no doubt that it will pass.
It's all new.
Brand new.
But you have to take, you've already voted to take that money for the standpipe.
25% towards.
So he'll just change the.
75% towards the standpipe.
Correct. So the point that we're trying to address is that you can't now spend it on the wells.
Well, I suppose we could change it at this rate, but it's not, that money on the wells is not coming from this cash. This will be paid for out of the cash fund that we already have.
As long as the cash flow represents that.
$200,000, we made a profit.
Ben, let me explain. You cannot move money.
I'm not trying to move money.
Just let me explain, as the treasurer of this district. You earmark the money to go to a certain account.
I understand.
Okay, you cannot move the money until you go to district meeting.
I know this.
Okay, so I'm just making it clear for the record that you're moving the money to standpipe, 75%.
Yes.
In March or April.
We voted on this already, and that the money that we're going towards district meeting is coming from something else.
Let me finish, don't interrupt me, please. I don't want anybody from the commissioners or the superintendent to come into my office and ask me to move money from the standpipe to a well renovations, because it's not going to happen. As long as you're clear that you voted 75-25, you're given the opportunity now, if you want to meet with the commissioners, with the PRUCON, to change your percentages, you can rescind that vote.
We can wait a year. I just want this thing to pass.
So you're saying, so the money that.
We have about 200K in the free cash fund.
To cover the expenses, what you.
We have about 200K in the free cash fund. In our M&O, we have about, what, 118,000, 20,000?
Yes, about that.
Okay. The well money, and this is what I was trying to say, is coming out of the free cash.
I know that.
All right? It's not coming out of the M&O, and it's not coming from the 75%. So we can wait another year and go to district meeting for anything else we need.
Sure. Makes sense.
That's what I'm trying, that's all I was trying to say.
Okay, I just want to make it clear for the record.
Okay, thank you. Again, back to the motion. Any further discussion on the motion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? 3-0-0.
Thank you.
You're up.
Thank you. Thank God.
I am so glad that is.
Me too.
Put to sleep. That's been a long process.
Now we can get to serious work.
Do you understand why I did it?
Oh, I do. I understand.
And I hope you I hope you sincerely respect the position that we were put in, because it doesn't seem that way when you come to us saying that you need this money to fix projects, and then we've discussed where the money was going to go, etc. We haven't even.
I don't know who discussed what. I can tell you this, is that we voted 25% as a fig leaf, as a token of goodwill.
It's
OPEB. We did that as a token of goodwill. Now,
as an obligation of the law.
There have been no violation of the law as far as I know.
No, I didn't say violation. I said as an obligation to the law. You have to fund your OPEB, and the prior boards have not been doing that.
Well, if they didn't have to, then. If they had to, then why didn't they? I mean, I'm not going to get into this minutiae. I'm not getting into the weeds of this stuff, right? I understand that you're upset about this. We just have a lot of work to do. It's not about ego for me. It's about getting the job done. That's all it is for me. It's nothing else.
And that's
honest,
what our job
please
is,
take
too.
Me at my word on this. It's nothing else. Please.
I have seen nothing.
And yet. Also, Ben, let me state for the record, also as a treasurer, when you go up for bond, you have to have OPEB. You have not funded your OPEB. We have close to $1 million on the district.
We tried
side.
To fund it.
You tried to fund it, and you have no money. So.
Well, we do now.
Well, you do now, and just for the record, as Pam said.
You would have had it, and we have it
excuse
now.
Excuse us. Let the treasurer stay her peace, please, Ben. Okay?
I will, but I feel
this
like
this isn't
I'm
an
getting,
argument.
You know.
I'm just letting you know, as a treasurer, Ben, and I'm not arguing. I'm making a statement, so that it's totally clear for the record that OPEB has to be funded. Even if you put $5,000 away a year, you're making the intent. And when you go up for bond and you need to borrow money, it's favorable for the district because they look at that as an asset.
That's why we did it, because you explained that to us, and that's why we did it.
The more we put towards OPEB, it just...
That's the whole reason we did it.
It doesn't have better positions.
Explain that to us in the first place.
Yes, I did.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dan.
I'm sorry if I was a little...
Excited?
Just, it's been a long...
Came in like this.
Oh, stop, buddy.
Hey, gonna have a piece of candy.
I can't have any more candy. I have to go home now. It's been two meetings and work and kids and... I'm gonna go home and have a drink.
Sounds like a plan.
Where do you live?
Planet Earth, my friend.
Planet Earth, okay. I'll be by for a cold one.
Charlie, you can meet me at Stevie's anytime you like. Peerview/Stevie's. Anytime you like.
That's after district meeting. Yes, we did that.
The meeting after the meeting?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Hi, Ben. Have a good night.
Thank you, Ben. Okay, fire station building committee.
Well, the fire station building committee, we didn't meet this last Tuesday. Because they, you know, we had met as a municipal committee to approve the OPM.
Well, we didn't have...
Yeah, but the meeting was before, so we didn't meet, so there's really nothing to discuss. At this juncture.
So, I know that I've emailed you a couple of times, and Chief would like the prudential committee to be at the...
Correct.
Fire station building committee on Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. The 14th.
The 14th.
At 5 o'clock.
At 5 o'clock.
At 5 o'clock, because KPA is doing a proposal, and the chief's kind of holding out the discussion.
Well, that's going to be questionable, because I received a, email from Kathy.
Yeah, she wants a discussion, and she want, and, you know...
I intend on attending.
I'm going to try to be there.
Okay, I have to be there.
Here, you have a...
But I would not want us to have to take a vote on something.
You can't anyway until, without the whole prudential committee being present.
No, the fire station...
Well, we would have a quorum.
They can make a...
I don't want you and I to have to be put in a position to take a vote without...
No, I wouldn't allow it, I would just say it has to be with the whole prudential...
It's supposed to be a joint.
Yes.
It is supposed to be a joint meeting, and really, the fire station building committee is going to make a recommendation to the prudential committee on which way they want to go, or the architects, whether they want to, after listening to Castle Blue's presentation, entering into negotiations with Castle Blue's, you have to do the same negotiations to see what percentage they're going to charge for the architectural.
For the architectural services, correct.
Even though we're going to be in attendance at this meeting, we won't be voting on any recommendations.
If we're in attendance, so it has a quorum. That's, I think, why the chief wants us there, so we can move the steps forward and not wait for another meeting to then move forward.
Because you're not meeting again for business until December.
Yeah, until December.
You don't have another business meeting until December.
Well, that's a tax classification, but that's all that's on the agenda.
Correct.
So
I'm just saying what the...
I thought you wanted to say to listen to KBA's presentation and not to make a decision.
Well, I think he
because
has
we still have to do interviews.
Honestly, I don't think
with whoever we decide.
I don't think we could determine the difference so that the whole presidential committee
can
make a decision.
But anyway, anything else about fire station building?
Oh, this is what the chief said to me. He sent me a text message last Friday, and he asked me to put KBA on the agenda. I told him I would do it. He said, thanks so much. Just spoke to Charlie. He wants to do PUCOM also, so they can act on proposal if needed.
Was to listen to the proposal.
Well, I'm just saying
if the committee decides they want to act on it, I certainly entertain it.
Yeah, but we still have to bring it back to the...
My thought was if Castle Hughes is giving a presentation, here with their presentation involved.
Yeah.
Because you still have to negotiate with them.
Exactly.
And then, what is Plan B, in my mind? What if they came in and said they wanted 6% as architectural fees of the total cost? We have to have a backup plan. Well, you know, that's way out of line with what architectural plans have cost in other projects. So we need to have Plan B and Plan C, just as we had when we interviewed the people for the.
But my other concern is that